Hey folks, Casey Dimon here with the TaxSawAcademy.com, and in this video we're talking about a huge step of your tax law research, and that is to check the local maintenance requirements. And again, I can't emphasize this enough, it's a huge part of your tax law research. And I promise you, by checking the local maintenance requirements, you're going to save yourself from a lot of headaches and a lot of hassles. And I speak here from personal experience. When I started investing in tax law properties, I invested locally. You know, I kind of grew up in the area and I knew everything just about possible when it comes to investing in real estate in that particular area. Then I started expanding my target areas more and more away from me until eventually I was investing in areas on the other side of the country. You know, I thought, hey, it can't be that different than the local area that I, you know, grew up in, is it? Well, as a matter of fact, it's a lot different. You know, different areas have different customs and different formalities. You know, they expect different stuff. You know, on the opposite side of the country, they have maintenance requirements that I thought were absolutely crazy and absolutely silly. You know, I didn't go by these maintenance requirements. I just kind of ignored them, if you will. And, you know, lo and behold, I started getting nasty letter after nasty letter after nasty letter. You know, with the threat of fines and all sorts of other fun stuff. So, what maintenance requirements am I talking about here? Well, you know, they vary from state to state and from county to county, from city to city. And we'll get into more information on that here in a second. But here are a few examples. You know, the first one is if there's debris in the yard. You know, say you buy a vacant piece of property and it's the only vacant property on that lot. Could potentially the neighbors have put their limbs in the yard, or could they, you know, possibly even put trash in the yard? Well, guess what? That's your responsibility to clean up. And, you know, and many cities will have that your lot has to be free of, you know, debris and free from limbs and all sorts of other stuff. So that is a maintenance requirement. Another one, especially in the northern states, of course, is the sidewalks have to be snow plowed. They don't allow any accumulation of snow in a lot of areas. So if you aren't there to plow, you know, the snow off your sidewalks, that could potentially be a maintenance violation. Another one here is if you buy a house, you know, say it's a dilapidated house, you know, say there's a few broken windows here and there. Well, some cities actually require all your windows and all your doors to be in perfect working order. Otherwise, you're violating the local maintenance laws, you know, the local ordinances and all sorts of other good stuff. And the last one here, last example, is one of my personal favorites. This is your grass has to be mowed. Yes, believe it or not, a lot of cities, you know, even for a vacant lot, will tell you your grass can only grow 3 inches or 4 inches. You know, that's only this much. So you have to literally mow your grass every couple of weeks. So, you know, if you're not local to the area, you have to hire somebody to mow your grass. And guess what? If you don't mow your grass, they're going to send you a nasty letter. They're going to fine you and potentially threaten jail time. And yes, that has happened to me in the past, but we'll save that for a future video. So, you know, there's a lot of different things that these counties and these cities will require. You know, as you develop as a tax law investor, you'll start learning which areas to avoid. You know, obviously the areas that require the grass be mowed, you know, I try to avoid those areas just because I don't want to have to deal with that situation. But how can you check their maintenance requirements? Well, you know, the easiest way is to call the city or the county, call their building or their code enforcement department, and simply ask them. Tell them who you are. You know, be honest with them. Say, I'm a tax sale investor looking at investing in tax sale properties in this city or this county. You know, number one, it shows them that you are a responsible first person. And, you know, and number two, they'll be more than happy to help you because they want responsible, law-abiding citizens who will maintain their properties. So they'll be more than happy to tell you the maintenance requirements in their city or their county. So I hope this has helped you and possibly saved you a lot of headache and a lot of hassle and maybe even jail time, you know, in your quest to become a successful tax sale investor. If you'd like more information about the very lucrative tax sale investing business, head on over to my website at thetaxsaleacademy.com. And you can do that by clicking the blue link right here next to my head. Again, it'll take you to thetaxsaleacademy.com. Have a great day, folks. Take care. Bye-bye.